Going on, guys. Welcome, Rabid here, and it looks like Karlsen forked a day earlier than expected. So coming into here, they did put the announcement yesterday at 2:59 a.m. that the new Karlsen desktop wallet is available for KarlsenhashV2. Remember, the mainnet hard fork is scheduled for the 13th, which is tomorrow at the time of recording, at approximately 1337 UTC. And then today at 8:46 a.m., about 2 hours ago at the time of recording, this occurred earlier than expected, but we have successfully passed the block height they needed, and the hard fork has been completed. Please make sure to update your miners to Karlsen V2. So today, I'm going to be showing you how to mine Karlsen on the new hard fork. So the first thing you are going to need is the new wallet, which was updated yesterday here. So scroll on down and we can see windows.exe. So simply click on that and download it. So once you get that all done, you should come in to get your wallet address. Now it does sound like there's some issues with importing, and you have to import to get your new things on the new chain and algorithm and everything. But I would just recommend start a new wallet. That'll be the fastest way to be up and running. Then later on, when everything gets kind of worked out here, you can just transfer your coins over to your new wallet or vice versa, and whatever you want to do. So that would be the fastest option I would take, which is what I just did here. But now you can see my new receiving address. So this is the address we're going to be mining to. All right, so once you have your wallet address set up, now we need a miner, and it looks like LOL miner version 1.89, which is the latest added support to mine Karlsen V2 on NVIDIA, as well as RX 5000 and newer AMD GPUs. So 5700Xs and so far, plus all those NVIDIA GPUs, are able to use LOL Miner for this latest hard fork. This is pretty much the same as Fishhash. So if you mined Ironfish, since it forked, you use the same overclock settings. All right, so once you do get it all extracted, you'll get a list of bat files here, and just scroll down until you do find Karlsen. So it should be down here somewhere. So I pre-made one for Hero Miners. I'm gonna set this up from scratch so that you guys can obviously see it and make it nice and easy for you. So you're going to want to come down to this W10 here, and this is where you're going to have to adjust. That already has Algo Karlsen V2 pool, so we're going to change this to our pool parameter. So we're just going to backspace that out of here and come into Hero Miners. And today's sponsor for this video is Hero Miner. So we're going to come in here and copy a stratum that's closest to you. So we're going to right click this, copy. The pool is all set up and ready to roll for this fork here, and we're going to come back in and paste that in like so. So now we can see here, --pool, us.karlsen.herominers.com with my port 1195. Next up, we do have to put in our wallet. So I'm gonna come back here, get rid of this here, and now I'm gonna find my wallet addresses, which is all here. So Karlsen desktop, I'm gonna copy this one and pretty much paste that in the exact same spot here under user. And now you wanna worker name. So we're gonna put in Rabid WS, that will be our worker name here, and then simply save this. So we're going to save that like so. I'm not going to put in any extra parameters or anything because I like to do my overclocking through LOL Miner. But first, I want to make sure this is working. So I'm just going to close this out now, and we're going to come back into those bat files, and I'm going to run it. So right now we're connecting. Yep, looks like things are going in. Drivers detected, authorized worker, start mining, granted light cache for fish hash. So yeah, everything looks like it is working. I'm going to wait a couple seconds here and do make sure we are detected at that pool. So coming back into the Hero Miner site, we're just going to scroll on down, and where it says your stats and payment history, pretty much paste your wallet address in there and look it up. Scroll on down and we can see Rabid Workstation is here. It hasn't been long enough to see any hash rate or shares or anything, but we can see they are talking to each other. So that's a good thing. Now let's step into some overclock settings. All right, so just coming into hashrate.no here for the RTX 4090, which is in my workstation. They're saying for Ironfish, because it is the same algorithm, so you're going to be using the same overclocks, that they don't have an offset set. I still always like to set 300 here. Core clock lock, we're going to lock at 2000, and a memory clock offset for Windows 1000, and you double that for Linux here, 2000 in Linux. So we're going to lock our core here at 2000, and then we're going to set in a 1000 offset. So simply come into your LOL miner here, go to the LOL miner GUI, right click that, and make sure you run it as an administrator. More information, yes, run anyway. Let that do its thing. Open, yep. All right, load up here for us. There we go. So now we're gonna make sure we're on the proper one. So I'm gonna click that off. So we're setting a core clock lock, we're setting a core offset, and we're doing a memory offset. So our memory offset was 1000. We're setting an offset 300, and then we're locking our core to 2000. Just double check our settings here, 2000, yep. Yeah, core clock 2000 here, memory offset of 1,000 for Windows. All right, we're all good. I'm not setting a power limit because we are locking our core, so that should be setting a power limit. Anyway, you can set one for safety, but I never do it. So if I apply those OCs, now I'm going to bring up Afterburner, and we should see that apply. So here we can see slightly over 2,000 here. So we're going to come back in and start our miner now. So I'm going to come back, double-click here, and we should begin hashing here right away. Going to make it a little bigger so we can see things, as well as bring up, you can see our memory and Afterburner will start spiking as it just did already. 1,100, 251 with a locked core of about 2,000. I don't know why it's 10 over. Should be locked at 2, but it doesn't matter. Now you can see we are hashing away. It's going to take maybe about 20 to 30 seconds to get up to full hash rate, but we are up and mining Karlsen hash on the V2 fork. All right, so now let's jump into HiveOS, and the first thing you're going to want to do is make sure you are updated to the latest version. I just went to the latest beta version. That has been a while since I had my test bench online, but now we're going to make sure we are on the latest of the updates for Hive. So make sure you click on Force Upgrade, Reboot After Upgrade, and then upgrade your miner. Now, while you're waiting for that to happen, we're going to add our wallet and everything. So we're going to come into our wallets here, add wallet, type coin and ticker. We're going to go Karlsen. So Karl, looks like Karlsen isn't in here. Maybe it's under something else. KRS, is it? No, they don't have it. All right, anyway, so Karlsen, click there. Address, we're going to find our wallet address here and put that in like so. Copy your address, right click, copy, paste that in, and then our wallet name, I'm going to call this Karlsen. Actually, it only pops up, so I'm just going to call this Node Wallet or GUI for our desktop wallet type of thing, and then create that wallet. So now we're going to make our flight sheet. So we're going to come into our flight sheet here, type coin and ticker. We're going to go Karlsen again, now that we have our wallet made, and then we're going to pick our Node GUI, which we just made, select our pool, configure that in the miner, and then we're going to select LOL miner. So we're going to click on that and then name this Karlsen Hero Miner so that you do know what pool you are mining to. All right, so we're going to click on Setup Miner Config here, and then we're going to select our algorithm, Karlsen. It doesn't have V2 in here yet, so we're going to put in our wallet here, followed by our period and our worker name. You can put your worker name in the other one. I don't think we need it, but you never know. Try it anyway. So we're going to put worker name right here. So now we need our pool and our port. So we're going to come into Hero Miners here again. Go all the way up here, and we can see North America, USA West. Again, always choose the closest stratum for you. Mine is USA West. Come back in, and we're going to go pool server. We're going to get rid of our port, though, because in LOL Miner, it's a little bit different. So we're going to cut that out and put it right here. So our port goes right there. So now you can also set up your extra config arguments, which is where you put in all your overclocking stuff. We're going to do that after here. We're going to make sure everything's working. So I'm going to apply those changes and create that flight sheet. All right, so earlier I showed you where you could put your auto overclocks into the extra config. HiveOS added all this stuff in over the past few months here for you can do it yourself. So you can actually lock your cores and set offsets and all sorts of stuff within that. So that's how we're going to set this up. So we're going to come into our overclocking here and see what hashrate.no does say to do. Now it's saying lock our core at 810. Let me know if that's correct. That seems like a type of memory lock here. Maybe they have something backwards, but we're going to try it and see what happens. So I am going to lock this to 810. I'm still going to be setting offset, even though it says not set here, to 300, and we are in Linux, so we are actually setting an offset of 2000. So 810 and 2000. So I'm coming back into here, and we're going to go an offset again. I'm going 300 on my offset. Now here it's saying locker core at 810, so we'll see what happens there. And then for a memory clock, we're not locking anything here. We want 2000 on our memory, so I'm going to apply that, and it should put everything in there like so. So there we go. Core is under offset. I wish it said core off because it's kind of confusing. Now you're thinking your core is actually at 300 when that's in fact the offset. Our locked core is 810 here. So now we're going to have to come into the LOL Miner GitHub because this was released an hour ago. This isn't on HiveOS yet. So we're going to have to come in and copy this command. So right when we go like this, right click, we're going to copy it, come back into our HiveOS, and we're going to run the flight sheet we just made. And then the command we just copied, we're going to run it to overwrite it. So we're going to paste this in, or I guess send this to the moon so it begins mining. As soon as it does start off here, we're going to wait a couple seconds for it to actually do its thing. You can SSH into your rig like so, and we'll just have a quick look to make sure it's running. Should be by now. Yes, it is. It's downloading it. Make sure it does start running. 1.88. Do its thing. La, la, la. It's going to give us errors because Karlsen hash isn't yet in here on the 1.88 version. So once it's done its thing here, we'll just wait. All right, so it's on 1.88 here. So now we're going to come back into here and we're going to click on run command and paste all of that in. We're going to hit the run command on that. And now it should overwrite 1.88 with 1.89. And now we can see 1.89 is installed. Okay, so you can see we are getting rejected shares. So now we're going to go into our flight sheet here, and then we're going to edit it. And in the extra config arguments, we have to tell it to run the latest Karlsen hash. So the V2 fork here. So coming into LOL miner, and I just want to find the algo here. Use A-A Karlsen V2. So I just want to make sure dash A or the one I put in is worked. We'll just, you know, fix it as we go here. So paste. Apply changes, update that, and see if we get any rejected shares or not. All right, so now it looks like it is working. It took a little longer to load up here, and we can see accepted share, where previously it was saying rejected, unaccepted here. So if we come in, we should start seeing accepted. There we go. So just for a quick reference again to kind of go over it all, because it's not added into HiveOS, you have to tell it to mine the new algorithm that they did fork to, which is Karlsen V2. And here's your command dash dash algo, and then put that algo in. That way it's not talking to that. Now, once HiveOS does update this, you will not need to do this anymore. The algorithm will be able to be added in up here, but you do have to force the algorithm right now because you are updating the older miner manually in HiveOS. And coming into Hero miners here, we can see test bench is detected, Rabid workstation is detected. It's estimated about $2 a day, which is pretty decent actually. We'll see what happens when the test bench kicks in, because this was purely on the 4090 alone. But there we go, guys. This is how you mine Karlsen on their latest hard fork to Karlsen V2, which is pretty much the same as the Ironfish algorithm to Hero miner. So thank you for watching this. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.